بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Now this is a pronunciation exercise from what we learned so far. So the first one is it's banu, banu. Next one is bu and nu, so it's bunu. Next one we see is has a long vowel, so it's bana, not bana, bana. Next one, there's a sukun there on the vowel, so it's bona, bona. Next one is a long vowel as well, it's the u sound, so it's buna, buna. Then next is bayna. Then we have bina. This is a long vowel, bina. And finally, it's bayana. So there's a shadda there. So it can actually be written as follows: the ba, then the ya, followed by another ya, and then finally the noon. So bay ya na. So when there's a shadda, there's a double letter. The first letter has a sukun, and the second has the haraka that it has, which is here the fatha. So bayana. Now let's go to the five words below. We'll pronounce it and give you the meaning. So the first word is fi. So you notice there's the elongation, the long vowel. Fi means in, and that in could either be physical or abstract. So if we say fil bayt, in the house, or it could be abstract. For example, if I say fi ra'yi, which means in my opinion. Okay, next we have, and you notice here the long vowel as well, rana. And rana is a verb which means to cover in dirt or rust. Next word is kayfa, kayfa. Kayfa means how. So for example, if you meet somebody and say kayfa haluka, how are you? Next word, huda. Now this is not actually a ya, it's an alif. It's called an alif maqsura, and it's exactly like an alif, the way it's pronounced. It's like a ya without the two dots. So we say huda. There's the elongation as well, because of the fatha followed by an alif. If this wasn't there, it'll be huda, but huda with the alif. Finally, we have the verb kassara, which means to smash something into many pieces. It's an intensive form. With verbs, when we have the shadda, the verb involves intensity. And you can actually feel it the way it's pronounced, kassara instead of kassara. So once again, there's the kaf followed by two sins, and then the ra. So kas sukune sara, kassara, not kassara. So it's very important with the shadda to give it the double sound. And sometimes people might be a bit too hasty and not give that double letter. My best advice to you is maybe go through the Quran and try to read it, and have, for example, a recording of it, a clear recording, and see if you pronounce it this exactly the same way. I must warn you, there are many rules that might cause you to be a bit confused, and you might ask, why is it recited in this way? It should be this way. But usually, most words in the Quran will be recited the way that they are written. So we finish the pronunciation. وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.